still a top Democratic strategist, Obama. Recent history suggests winning here in Southeast Ohio equals winning the White House. Democrats retired this region only 3 times in the last 10 presidential elections, 1976, 1992, and 1996. It just happened to be the party's only 3 White House victories in the past 40 years. In Portsmouth's bustling Market Street Cafe, there is a hopeful vibe for Democrats. The younger staff is all for a month. But Warner Mary Ray, loyal Republican, he's a giant generational divide.
I think people are more of my age than you for the pain. But I just feel, you know, overall, that there is more of a
homophobia. I've seen that local Democratic headquarters is now fixed. An office worker felt compelled in a flash on a cardboard along the lookout. The overwhelming issue here is jobs. Just 8 weeks to election day. Local Democrats are still replying to rumors their candidates won't wear a flag and Mr. Christian, looking Senate over on Quran, not a Bible.
I have that question all the time. People that I talk to in our community still have great reservations about that.
Many older Democrats were seized early and often tough to break through.
There's no doubt in my mind that Senator Obama is not left on the edge. He's not a left-wing crazy.
Jean Carlson is an old water Republican. Obama Democrat. She's expressing not letting his faith as the detail of racism. Local Republicans say the race factor is exaggerated, and Obama is just too liberal for his parts. Whatever the reason, Obama's chance to make history could rest on whether he can change perceptions in small towns or change. Always welcome. John Sands, CNA, Portsmouth, Ohio.
Joe Biden claimed policies of stem cell research. These people claim he is, but taking payments are beyond the latest on the story. And a fact check from Charlie is coming out. And later, DPL is part of the Van Library Books in Alaska Town. She also tried to make creationism a part of the school curriculum. No, and no, in both cases, those just two of the many rumors swirling about the candidate. We'll see what's true and what's not. Here's some 360 photos that are another chance of speaking to supporters at an Obama rally in Tampa, Florida. That word tonight, Joe, in the caption, just when I thought I was out, they pulled me back in. Which was, thank you. You can do better. Go to our website, ac360.com. Click on the B360 link, send us your entry. We'll ask for whatever you have for them. We're appropriate for the T-shirt. Through our eyes.
Scientists believe this could change the way we see our universe, but at least one critic fears the experiment could have devastating consequences.
This is not rocket science. It's much more complicated than that. The Large Hadron Collider is the most powerful atom smasher ever built. And when scientists switch it on tomorrow, we could discover a world of cosmic rays, dark matter, and black holes right here on Earth. To do that, scientists have built a 17-mile tunnel 300 feet below Switzerland, where protons will collide at near the speed of light. The objective is out of this world, to simulate the Big Bang, or the birth of our universe.
We expect to learn the most basic structure of matter from which the universe is built. It's the building blocks. This is very fundamental science.
Can his stronger claim, Professor Otto Rosler, who went to court to stop the experiment, warning the Earth could be eaten inside out.
How many months or years it takes to eat the whole Earth cannot be predicted at the moment. It probably depends on what types of quarks the black hole came to eat first.
Nonsense, say the scientists.
Are you messing with Mother Nature?
Absolutely not. We're trying to see Mother Nature. We're trying to measure Mother Nature.
That hasn't stopped the skeptics. Some scientists have received death threats. Outside safety experts were called in and they give the project a green light. The experiment is powered by these giant magnets, and the director of the program says if something were to go wrong, he could shut the entire system down in less than a second. But it will take years to gather the data, and perhaps decades to find to man's oldest question. Where do we come from?
In the past 20 years, childhood obesity